Well, hello everybody, Granny's back. And so is Tommy. Yes, Tommy is back as well. He's my boyfriend. No, not my boyfriend. He's my kitten friend. Yes, I love him. And I am dusting the table a little bit. It's the shiny table from Fonne, you know. And you see all particles of dust. And this is a schotelvod, a dishcloth. But you can use it as a dust cloth as well. So like this, it's clean. It's just out of the washing machine, so it's clean, and then you can dust with it. Oh, it's a multi-purpose thingy. But in the distance, you can see what I'm going to use today. Not that one, but that, and that is what we are going to make. And over here is little Tommy. And I've got myself my coffee. It's still hot, so I can't take a sip. See, Tommy, it's hot coffee. Yes, you don't like hot coffee. Neither do I. Yes, we love each other, don't we? He's such a sweet boy. Such a beautiful boy. His hair are very long. Maybe he needs to see a capper. So to cut it a little bit. Because he has very long hair. Yes. Oh, such a sweet boy you are. Yes. Oh, we love you. But when I'm going to crochet, you need to get out of the way, Tommy. Hey, you little pastry. You little tompoesje. Yes. You're not little anymore. You're a big boy now. Oh, I've got to tell you something. Fonne asked a lot of Facebook followers how they felt about me speaking Dutch or me speaking English. And most people said, we want Granny to speak Dutch. Oh, that's a pity, because Granny isn't speaking. Leave my stitch marker alone. You naughty boy is mine. So, because Granny doesn't speak Dutch in the tutorials she makes. She wants Fonne to go international, so she speaks English. And if you don't like that, then I am very sad, but that's the way it is. That's the way the cookie crumbles. Speaking of cookies, I don't have a cookie. I'm going to fetch myself a cookie in a minute. But first, the bell. Well, there was the bell, wasn't it? It was the mailman. And he brought Fonne another birthday gift from her son. Her son sent it in time, but yeah, post is very busy this time of year. So it arrived just now, and Fonne asked me to show you. Look, he sent her a beautiful plant with a pot, always handy. A pot erbij en een embroidery ring. Is dat de naam? Frame. Embroidery frame of beechwood. Van Prim. En Fonne is very busy with embroidering. En this is very useful. So, a present from her son. And in this little bakje, there are some aquarium plants from his own aquarium. And since it's been in the mail for a week, the water was very cold and no more oxygen in it at all. So I thought, you know what, let me put it in some clean cold water. And then let it reach the room temperature. It can revive, say. And then over here, there's a little plant. A seedling from his own aquarium. With very long roots on it. And what's this? Is this a little piece of stone? Yes, that was a little piece of stone. Very long roots, so it will settle quite well. But first, let it adjust to the room temperature. And all this green This green, that's moss. See, that's moss. And it's not looking too fancy, so we will have to revive it really well. So we give it a chance first in this cold water. It's clean water, same temperature as it was from the mail. So now the temperature can rise. Now my fingers are wet. It can rise very slowly to room temperature. And then when Funne puts it in her aquarium, the difference is it not so great, because it was about 5 degrees or something, that water. That's very cold. And the temperature in her aquarium is 24 degrees Celsius, you know. So when it gets to room temperature, it only has to overcome a couple of degrees in a very short period of time. And now it can take its time to warm up a little. It won't get winter toes, you know. So let's put this aside, and the beautiful plant. Oh, it is so lief on him. Really, he knows his mother. But now I have to dust again. See at the table, it is dirty. So I have to dust it again. Hooray for this cloth you can use as dust cloth. Oh. So, and in the meanwhile, I got myself a cookie as well. Soft cookie, but there were nuts on it. And those nuts I can't bite without my teeth, you know. So I gave the nuts to Krakow. That's why he is so still. He is eating nuts. He loves nuts. So, and the coffee must be chilled down a little bit. Let me take a sip. Mm. Yes, perfect temperature. And now let's get the crochet stuff. Where was the stitch marker? Oh, now I lost the stitch marker. Well, I get the new one. What have I got? I have got some underputters. 3 of those. And 2 the same but a different color. Look at that. I will put the camera a bit down like that. So you don't see all the other stuff. See, these are 3 with a bit orangey color, and these are lilac, I think the color is, light purple. And I am going to make another one in this color. And then I have a complete set. Funne made these for Christmas especially. And these are gorgeous as a gift, as a set. I've used the Cotona cotton, this one, it's from Scheepjes, you know, Cotona. And I have crocheted this needle. Is it going to sharpen? Yes, 3.5 millimeters. But when you have different yarn, it's okay, just take a needle and it will be okay. Underputters you can crochet even in acrylic yarn. That won't take as much moisturizing when you spill, you know, when you knoei. But it's not the bedoeling that you knoeit natuurlijk. So, acrylic also well. But when you have red wine or I don't know, that you don't get the stains out. Acrylic can't be washed in the wash machine as hot as cotton. So make a choice. It's always right. So how do we begin? We begin with a little cookie. And then I lost my stitch marker, but I can do without. It's not a problem. It's not such a difficult dusting again. I look like a housewife. All the dusting. I don't like dusting. We are going to start with a tail to easily sew away. And then we are going to crochet 3. I don't remember. Let me try. 1. 2. I'll make it three. 3 tens. That's enough. A little bit more like that. Yes. 3 tens. That's enough. And now you are going to crochet. To crochet 12 double crochets. And those first 3 stitches don't count for anything. In the very first chain, you are going to crochet 12 double crochets in the first one. So we don't start with a magic loop. We don't start with 4 single crochets to make it a little circle. No. We use the first chain to make a circle. So now I have got 1 and 2 double crochets, and that should be 12. So this is 3, all in the same first chain. And this is 4, and 5. Oh, I am completely relaxing. And 6, 7, 8. Let me get some yarn. It's 100% cotton, eh? How many did I have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 4 more. This is 9, 10, 11, and 1 more. This is 12, and you see it all fits into that very small stitch, the first chain. Now you find your first double crochet, that's this one. Those 2 on the side don't count. You skip those 2. You go to the first double crochet and you close your round with a slip stitch, like that. And now you have a very tiny hole in the middle, but when you sew your tail away, the hole closes. You see, quite a bit. There can be a little hole in the circle, but that's not a problem. Well, the next round. First coffee. We are going to crochet half double crochets. I like half double crochets. Each stitch gets 2 half double crochets. We have 12 stitches, so we end up with 24 half double crochets. I start with 1 chain, and then in the stitch I closed, 2 half double crochets. 1 and 2. In the next one, number 3 and number 4. Number 5 and number 6. 7, 8, and the next one, number 9, and number 10, number 11, number 12. I need a sip of my coffee. Remember, number 12. I stopped at number 12. I love coffee. 12. So I'm on the half. 12. 13. And 14. 15. And 16, 17. 18. I think Tommy fell asleep somewhere. I can't find him. He was with me in the kitchen when I got myself my cookie and took care of the water plants. But now he is gone. And the back door is closed because it is really bad weather outside. It's raining and it is storming. It's really harassed. As soon as it will be winter and then we will have snow. I love snow. Did you remember at which stitch I was? 18, I think. Then this is 19 and 20. Doris is sleeping on top of the crapple, all the way on the top, and Chrissy is sleeping on the couch, this 20, but where is Tommy? 21 and 22, usually he's doing something naughty. This morning he threw a vase off the vensterbank. Luckily it was a mess under the vensterbank and the vase fell on the mess and the mess didn't break. So the vase is still heel, not broken. But that's the things Tommy does. He is such a naughty boy. Okay, 22 and this is 23. I love Tommy. 24. Like that. And now you close your round on the very first half double crochet. Not the chain two we did in the beginning, but really on top of the first half double crochet. There you make a slip stitch. Like that. A slip stitch. A half a fasten. A slip stitch. And now you have done your first two rounds. We're almost done. Okay, let's continue with the next round, the third one. Now we are going to make these lovely stitches over here. Purl stitches. That's what we are going to do. And the first one is two chains. That will be our first double crochet stokje. Two. And then in the next stitch, you put one double crochet. I cut myself a little bit of my cookie. And you are going to pull up some loops around the post of the double crochet. So, yarn over. Around the post. Pull up a loop one time. Yarn over, around the post, pull up a loop two times and one more time. So three times you pull up a loop and then you yarn over and make it all the way through like that. And then you've got one loop left. In the next stitch, you do a double crochet. Don't skip stitches. Right in the next stitch, a double crochet. And now we have to make that loopy thing again. The purlo stitch. So, first in the next stitch, a double crochet. And then we are going to pull up some loops again. Just around the post of the double crochet. Not in the stitch, but really around the post. So, yarn over. And go around the post and pull up a loop. That's one time. Yarn over. Pull up a loop around the post. That's two times. Yarn over and pull up a loop around the post. Three times. And then you yarn over and you go through all the loops on your needle. And you've got one loop left. That's the purl stitch. And then in the next stitch we make another double crochet. Just like that. You see? And that's the way you go around. It's very easy. And because Ketona has a little shine on the thread, it looks very fancy, very chic, very expensive. And you can make a lot out of one skein of yarn. Because these two, I've already made with this skein. And you see how much I've got left. You can make a lot with one bolletje. And then it's not expensive to make. So, next purl stitch. One double crochet and picking up loops. So yarn around your needle and around the post you pull up a loop. One time. Two times. And three times. And then yarn over and pull your loop through all the loops. Like that. And a double crochet in the next stitch. And then you are ready to make another purl. See? Now you have three. Well, do this all the way around. You will end with the purl. And then I will be back. And you will have 12 of those purls. Okay, I've got one stitch left over here. Because this is the closing stitch, the slip stitch. You don't count that one. That is a fake one. He is fooling you. Don't buy that. The last stitch is going to be a purl. So, one double crochet in the last stitch. And then three times pull up a loop. With yarn over. Dus two yarn over. And three. And then through all the loops. And then you close your round in the chain. The second chain. There you close the round with a slip stitch. And I find it a bit difficult. But hey, girl power. Granny can do this. Yes, she can. Like that. And now you have 12 of those purls. You see that? And now you have to do two more rows. And then the little underputter is ready. So, first, chain one. And make a single crochet in the stitch you just closed. So, a single crochet. And if I could find one, I put a stitch marker in there. But it's not really necessary. And now you do three chains. One, two, and three. And then in the next double crochet, you skip the purl. And in the next double crochet, you do a single crochet. Like that. And then you have a little bow. You see? A little boogje. Three chains. One, two, three. And skip the purl. And in the next double crochet, a single crochet. Like that. And now you have two bows. Now this is what you do all the way around. One, two, three. Skip the purl. And in the double crochet, a single crochet. And then you have another little bow. You see? A boogje. Over here, and over here, and over here. And you will end up with 12 boogjes. And close the round in your first single crochet with a slip stitch. You can do that, right? I will be back when I am there. Finish my coffee and my cookie. Done! See? I've done it. All the way around these little bows. And now we are going to crochet in those bows. We are going to crochet three double crochet, two chains and three double crochet. Look, don't do anything but yarn over. So no, make no stitch. You've closed around with the slip stitch. And now we are going to crochet double crochets right away in the next bow. So, three double crochets. One. Two. And three. Tisa, you're not getting a cold, are you? That was Doris. And now, two chains. One and two. Een move overdoos, 3 double crochets en crochet 3 more double crochets. 1, 2, and 3. And then you do a slip stitch in the single crochet. The next one is a single crochet and you slip stitch over there. Like that. And now you have a little pointy thing. You see? Just like here, all those pointy things. And when you repeat this, you will have 12 of those pointy things. So, oh, look at that, I have to dust again. Wanna buy yourself a new table. Okay, in the next bow, 3 double crochets. So, 3 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3, and then 2 chains, and again 3 double crochets. And when you have to, just move over those double crochets so you have space to make another 3 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3. And then a slip stitch in the next single crochet. And that's what you do. And then when I am finished, I hope I am still in time to go to the bar. Yes, really, Granny goes to bars, only one bar. It's for Miranda. Such a sweet lady. She has an online bar at Handwerk Café. And I love it. But I have to finish this video first. So, 1 in the next bow, 2, and 3. Because Miranda always says, first the job, and then you can come to the bar. And then we will chit-chat, or we will handwerk together. It's so much fun. I really love it. Make it with Miranda, is it called. And there I go, online, on YouTube. Ha! It's fun! See? Now I have 3 in each bow. And when you are all the way around, I will be back. Well, when I am all the way around, maybe you aren't, but I will be. I just put on the little button on the camera, and then the camera doesn't film anymore. And I can crochet, and then when I am back, I put on the camera again. And then you see that I am finished. Oh. See, I'm at the end. I've got 12 of those pointy things, and now I am closing my round in that slip stitch I made to close the last round. Then I will make a slip stitch. Cut my golden pair of scissors back and cut the yarn. Pull it through one more time, like that. And then all I've got left to do is sew away this little piece of thread and the center piece of thread. And then we have another underputter. I love underputters. Look, now I've got 3 of those lilac colors. And I've got still got this left. I can make another 3 out of 1 little ball. You see? It's nice. You can use leftovers if you like. And I have got 3 of those a bit orangey ones. I love it. Ah, Granny's underputters. Hey, I wish you a lot of happiness crocheting these. And when you are making them as a gift, I am sure that the one who is getting them from you is going to be really, really happy. They are gorgeous. And you can make them in different colors. You can combine colors. The pearls that you do them in a different color. All to your imagination, you know. You can do it, really. That was my last sip of coffee. Now it's done. Oh, there's a little bit left. Wait a minute. Now it's done. Okay. I am going to close this video. And maybe you liked it. And then you can give a thumbs up if you like. If you don't like it, don't bother to put the thumb down. That's not necessary. And maybe you want to abonneer op Vonne's channel. How subscribe is that in English? But maybe you want to do that. And click on the bell and then you will get a notification if there is another video. And I promise I will be back. Really, I will be. Lots of happiness. And maybe this year of next year or the year after that, I will be back. Toodles!